Now, moving on to the human rights. Movements or approaches. In USSR. This has been a historical change which was not expected at all at any point of time. The change has occurred in such a scenario that the entire system of governance in USSR has got completely changed. The human rights are not at all given freedom for members in the USSR, because in USSR we have the continuous controlled system of socialistic setup, where even the farms or fields of agriculture are done by the government under the collective farming of agriculture, and there were no fundamental basic rights allowed to the people. As the movement was escalated and because of severe economic crisis, happened in early 1980s in East Europe, the many of the Eastern European nations are under the hold of USSR or influenced by the ideology of USSR, and they were expecting a helping hand at the times of trouble from USSR. As USSR, the big brother role for them, they were expecting a good helping hand in the form of financial and economical help. But in actual reality, there was a trouble even in the existence of USSR itself. The people started to ask, demand for better rights for them, because under the leadership of Mikhail Gorbachev has started the initiative of Glasnost, which is like giving a radical changes in the system by giving freedom for them. Till now, the USSR has not tasted any kind of freedom for them. But because of this Glasnost system of giving radical freedom for them, these people started to get questions, fundamental rights, uncensored newspapers. They can start questioning the government. They can publish anything else. These all things have brought out some drastic changes in the mindsets of the people of USSR. At this the same point of time, in the background, where the Eastern European countries are expecting some helping hand from USSR, could not reach to the maximum extent and could not at all do any service for them, because they are caught up with the internal problems what they are having, and in the process of journey, and we have a coup d'etat happening in Russia in relevance towards the Mikhail Gorbachev's government, and initially he bought the Boris Yeltsin emerged as a new president of USSR, and as soon as he emerged as new president of USSR, immediately he has disbanded all the nations groups not to be banned in USSR. They are free to form their independent nations, and it's not compulsory for them to be an ally of the emerging new nation of Russia. This made to get USSR dismantled in the year 1991. This dismantling of USSR has brought down the tensions in the entire world scenario of the Cold War concept, where USA and USSR were considered as the two X symbols of Cold War issues between the different nations, and they have taken different sides and fought for the last 46 years. The initiative was at the very par of excellence. The Cold War has seen the extreme phases in the last 46 years, but finally in 1991, after USSR got disintegrated and emerged into Russia and the allied nations, the Cold War concept has completely gone down or into the zero level status. In this way, it has emerged as a human rights approach towards a bloc nation, a controlled nation, to a free nation, where they have turned into a democratic presidential election systems, and now they are following the successful democratic setup which has been successful. Now we have the President Putin as the leader of the Russia, and he has been serving as president from the 2012 elections onwards. and he has been a competent leader, and he's going to give a tough fight for the world scenario that he is going to hold on Russia as a emerging fast developing nation. And there are no more words to say, like, it is a tough competitor to US.